My today's topic in power system instrumentation is disturbance recorders. Now, this disturbance recorder is being developed by Poland. So, it is one Polish instrument what we will describe over here. Now, if we will see over here, in this slide, you can see, we are just coming to this portion, just see. Other units of the recorder are ZSM. That means this is the portion which is present apart from all other units. Now here we can see Ethernet switch. It can be level 2, it can be say 2 layer or 3 layer, and of course Ethernet connection which is bidirectional present over here. We can see current and voltage present over here, and 4 to 20 milliampere of conversion from one particular value by the help of analog to digital converter we can see over here. Then we can see over here binary inputs in the form of zeros and one, and all of them are unidirectional. If we will go to the upward, we can see over there the recorder unit is present over here. With that, this is the particular unit. We can say this unit has multi-function touchscreen, just like our mobile phone. So here we can just choose any particular function, and we can see what will be the fault, what will be the disturbance with that. This is the digital fault recorder. Digital disturbance recorder, all those data will be stored in ROM, actually in non-volatile memory. This is the logics of measurements and of activations. See over here, it is present. If we will go upward, then we can see, of course, this is the bidirectional communication present over here. And in this side, we can see that this is actually the control of output for the signaling of that particular system. In the upward section, we can see over here, this is the actually the configuration or analysis stand for the control system. External communication, that is depending on logical demands, it has been given over here, and it is being controlled by RS-232 and Ethernet. Now if I will come to downwards, then here we can see the application. Disturbances, of course, it is one such type of thing which is unwanted in nature. This can cause breakdowns in the operation. This can cause breakdown for electrical power facilities, which will tend towards financial losses and other negative type of technical consequences. So if we will analyze all those previous incidents, then it will enable us to determine the causes of malfunctions. From there we can find the conclusions, and we can make some arrangement for troubleshooting so that we can avoid similar types of problems in future. Now this is the basic feature of this particular recorder. First of all, this is a microprocessor device which will record all analog and binary measurement signals from the specific connected equipment of the substation. Then it will record the data before, during and after the disturbance. So you can see over there, because in that particular log diagram, one non-volatile memory is present, all those data will be stored over there. Now it is equipped with two embedded independent software recorder modules. One is known as DFR and another one is known as DDR. DFR is digital fault recorder and DDR is dynamic disturbance recorder. The first one is very fast, the second one is slow. The first one is for fast changing disturbances, for which the time period will be very brief. All types of short circuits will come under this. And the second one, where it will be last for few minutes, but it can cause substantial risk to the system due to their application or due to their scope, and as for example power swings will come under this. Then you can see over here a particular disturbance that will be recorded in a way enabling proper observations and analysis, that is analog signals in the form of current and voltage from instrument transformers that can be recorded at a sampling rate up to 10 kilohertz for more than 20 seconds in standard configuration. And this dynamic disturbance recorder DDR is present over there. It can be set to record for even a few hours. Now there should be some kind of provision to create virtual channels for which we can say that we can record active and reactive power, positive and negative component, etc. And all these measurements will be based on the calculations from actual channels. Now it has got the ability to record 4 to 20 milliampere signals, as we have seen over there from the measuring transducers. It may be pressure transducer, it may be temperature transducer. After that we can see there will be a coordination between DDR and VFR, and there is an option to activate one or both recorders based on specific criteria. Then it can record sampled as well as calculated values, and that can be visualized simultaneously to analyze the interdependencies between the fast and slow changing disturbances. After that we can see there will be very easy installation procedure for the recorder, for their testing, for their configuration. Electrical Ethernet or optical fiber connection, you can see over here 100 base FX is written. It can be used for external communication. Other connectivity options are available as per request. However, we are assured of this particular thing that this mentioned solutions are recommended due to their speed. Now, optical communication with a monitoring system that will be based on ISC 61850 protocol, and that will be applicable for optical fiber according to client requirements. And it has got that ability to easily increase the number of recorded channels without any deterioration for the recording quality. That means there will be a substantial performance of recording quality. The supplied software that will enable configuration of recorder and full analysis of recorded data. It can also record up to 32 analog signals and up to 64 binary signals within a single unit. And it can also guarantee about the cooperation of a number of units in the recording system with simultaneous sampling and precise time synchronization. If at all the time synchronization will not be there, then the data will be erroneous. Then we can see that we can expand this recording system, which will not cause any deterioration of operating parameters. There will be a cooperation and synchronization of multiple units, which is based on optical fibers and Ethernet network. A recorder that is actually a multitasking device, and it is possible to download data and record simultaneously. There will be a front panel which is fitted with color touch screen. It will display the current status of the recorder. It will also display the notifications about full memory, and if at all there will be any malfunction, it will be displaying that thing also. And it will also display the last time each recorder was activated. It is also possible to preview the measurement status of binary inputs. It can set an interlock and change the device operating mode. Now the front panel, this is also fitted with a set of 8 configurable multicolor LEDs that will display information selected by the user from a list of logic signals. The memory is sufficient to store disturbance data for 1 year. There will be 100 fast changing for DFR and 75 slow changing disturbances for DDR without any data compression or zip. It can be powered from two independent sources. There will be several recorder modes. As we have seen over here, there are two recorder modes which we can choose. One is known as run till fill. That means when the memory is full, the recorder will be locked and it will notify to us that it is out of memory until there is a permission to override the data or delete some previous data. The second one is circular. Here the memory works in a circular mode. That means if it runs out of memory, then the oldest records will be deleted or overwritten. The configurable sampling frequency of DFR will be in this range. It may be 1 kHz, maybe 2, maybe 5 or maybe 10 kHz. Whereas for DDR, the dynamic disturbance recorder, it will be 0.1 Hz, 0.5 Hz or say 1 Hz or 5 Hz or 10 Hz or 20 Hz or 50 Hz. As per that, the time period can be determined. The maximum sampling frequency difference between channels in a single unit or one of the distributed recording system is of 5 microsecond, and these features is describing that there will be an insurance about the phase, small phase displacement. If there will be negligibly small phase displacement while we are calculating values from analog samples, it has got the ability to connect a center collecting data over an Ethernet LAN or WAN. That means the wide area network or local area network of the substation, and the recorder is also secured against any unauthorized access as per security aspect, with several password levels and a personal identification number or a PIN code for the front panel display. It has got the ability to connect a printer to a local station, and it can print specific records also. It has got the ability to assign weights to different triggers which are added up during the recording. Now if we will see the next feature, we can see over here, it has got the ability to create advanced recording trigger criteria based on logical conjunctions and disjunctions by the application of artificial intelligence with the use of AND as well as OR. Now you can see over here, these are the following inputs that can be connected to the logic gates. It can be divided into several. Just see, the first one is status of the binary signal. Second one is status of calculated signals, that means analog signals. First, as per this, the first is positive zero or negative sequence current. The second one is positive zero or negative sequence voltage. The third one is active power and its first derivative. The fourth one is reactive power and its first derivative. The fifth one is apparent power and its first derivative. And the last one is frequency and its first derivative. In case of this aforementioned calculated signals, it is possible to define the threshold, that is the minimum trigger values, and if at all there will be any hysteresis. It is also possible to activate specific signals that will be based on changes in their values over a definite period of time. In case of binary inputs, the following types of triggers can be defined. One is for falling edge. Falling edge means from 1 to 0. One is for rising edge, that is from 0 to 1. If we will come to the next point, we can see there are other two also. One is for high level, that is binary 1 plus 5 volt, and the other one is low level, plus 5 volt or very 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 near to plus 5 volt. The other one is low level, that is 0 volt or very near to 0. Now you can see over here, it can also give the status of the triggers of calculated signal, and it triggered, and this trigger criteria can be attached to recorded curves. Frequency criteria has got a resolution of 10 millihertz. What is the resolution? If there will be slightest change in the input, there will be subsequent change in the output, which is known as resolution, and it is also possible to activate the recording manually from the front panel of the device. Those records, they have defined recording pre-tilt trigger and post-trigger times and continuation time, and all those times will be saved in the memory, and we can change also those particular times. All the information that is necessary for analysis is attached to the disturbance record file in the count rate format. This is the particular format that is being generated by these police manufacturers. The recorder has an internal real-time clock just to provide the synchronized frequency, which can be synchronized to an external time source complaint with IRIGB or NMES standards with a 1 PPS signal. The time synchronization is subject to continuity and consistency conditions of time signal. That is, if the internal clock of the recorder will not be adjusted, if the read time signal does not differ from the previous reading, or it does not differ by a value either greater or lower than the time reading cycle, then there will be an error. The continuity condition has to be met by at least two previous readings. Now, you can see over here, there will be a wide range of signals which can be connected to contact outputs and LEDs to indicate alarms or operations of the device. After that, if we will see over here, we can see these particular recorders. This type of particular recorders are supplied with necessary software and full documentation in Polish language, which is required to design, perform independent configuration and facilitate the device operation. The manufacturer will provide assistance during designing of external circuits, performs the commissioning and periodical inspections of the supplied devices. Now, if we will come to the next part, this is the construction. You can see the front panel over here. The dimension is given over here in the millimeter. This will be made by Euro housing, and it is made of chromate plated aluminium. It will provide higher resistance to electromagnetic compatibility resistances. You can see over here that it is a multifunctional display. You can see over here several types of function, as well as LEDs will be present over there just to display the status. After this, the colored front panel, you can see over there, here are the signaling diodes. All the functions are given over here. This is the touch screen, multifunction touch screen, from where you can choose your particular function. This is the power supply and operation for signaling. This is particular part where you can find out where will be any particular fault. After that, we will come to the next portion, which is nothing but the LCD touch screen. The center of this front panel has a colored touch screen, you can see over here, which is allowing for checking recorder status, visualizing the post and pre-trigger times, as well as it will show us the measurements, and it will provide options to activate or lock the recorder. The default screen is the recorder, is for the recorder memory preview. This mode is actually displaying current available memory, how much available memory is there, and dates for the last triggers of particular recordings. After this, you can see over here, there are three types of options have been given. First one is activate, second one is options, third one is reset signal. What is activate? This is the manual activation of either DFR or DDR. That means digital fault, which is very fast, or dynamic disturbance, which is slow. The second one is showing for options. What is options? Switch to the option screens. And the third one is reset signal. It will confirm saved logic signals of the recorder. It also switches off the record LED activated after the last saved recording. Now, if we will come to the next one, you can see over here, this is the option screen where you can see there will be two type of operating mode. One is run till full, another one is circular. As we have told before also, run till full, it will wait until the memory will be full and then it will be locking it and await for the user to authorize overwriting chosen records. What is circular? The recorder saves the data in the memory base on the circular buffer principle. If it runs out of space, then it will be starting the overwriting for the older records. After that, we can see over here the calculated values. That means here we can just access the preview of the screen with the present values of configured calculated signals. We can see over here voltage voltage, volt is given, for current ampere, for power consumption watt is given, what is the frequency in which it is working, that is also being given over here. After that, if we come, we can see the trigger. Trigger, what it will do, it will press to access the preview screen with currently activated criteria for triggering the recorder. There is also a light which is activated if a different recorder unit in a distributed system signals about the activation, which is followed by binary input. Binary input means there will be button to that will be used to access a screen with visualization of logic states of binary input. Green light means logic state 1, while gray light means logic state 0 will be shown. Then analog inputs. If we will press to see the analog input screen, a list of all analog modules in the device will be displayed, and of course from these analog values we can convert this by the help of A to D converters to digital values also. After that, this is the confirm screen. It will confirm chosen interlocks and the operating mode. A 4-digit pin has been given as per our ATM pin also. That will be just for verification, and by the activation of that particular pin, the confirm screen will be enabled. So after this, we are coming to the return. Return means return to the main screen, and it will ignore any potential changes to operating modes and interlocks. We can see over here LED signaling power malfunction and operation. What it will do actually, when there will be any record, it will show red if a new recording was made but it was not read by the user or accepted with a reset signal button. Then malfunction, if there will be any internal malfunction, then yellow will be glowing, and that means that if there will be any problems with operation of the device are detected, that is internal or external communication errors, configuration errors, non-volatile memory errors, for all those things the LED light up also during initialization of the device for a few seconds after the power is turned on. If we are dealing with a distributed system of this recorder, then the main unit also indicates a malfunction of any of the secondary recorders by lighting this LED and simultaneous signal of the malfunction relay. What is for power? Power will be green if there is a power supply to the device. Additionally, there will be two top LED that will be indicating operation of a digital fault and dynamic disturbance recorder, and if both of them work correctly, then only the LED will be green. If any of them will be locked manually or say due to some activation conditions that being made for an extended period of time, the color will turn yellow. Then we can see over there, there will be 8 signaling LEDs and description fields for identification with a suitable name of the signal are located from left side of the LCD touch screen. Multicolor super bright red, green, blue, that means RGB LEDs, they will be functioning as optical indicators. It is possible to use software supplied with the recorder to select the preferred signals from a list available in the program. The LED color can also be figured from the software level as well. Here, after that, we can go to the next stage where we can see the rear panels and modules of this recorder. This is actually the rear panel where we can see the power supply, the current inputs, the voltage inputs, binary input, time synchronization, relay outputs, communication and logics. So all these are particularly configurable part of this particular unit, which is nothing but the rear panel of this disturbance recorder. So in the next lecture, I will cover operating